Y ahí tiene usted líder, por ejemplo. You have to be leader. As vice president, como vicepresidente de segundo bachillerato, tiene que ayudarle al presidente de tercero bachillerato, ¿no? Líder. Public speaking. Uy, public speaking. Tener, saber hablar adelante del público, adelante. Another, ¿no? So, equations, I told you, questions. So you say, endowed, be endowed, estar dotado con ese talento. Talk about natural talent, ¿no? Be born with, nacer con ese talento. Be blessed with, ser bendecido con. Be born, o be gifted, o be natural, ¿no? And come naturally to. So you say equations. Example, Jeff is good at solving equations. Y dice, he must have been born with those skills. Claro. Debe haber nacido con esas habilidades. I know, math just seems to come naturally to him. Y hay una frase, que un dicho dice, ¿no? Que si usted aprendió a caminar y no... Bueno, usted para aprender a caminar tiene que aprender a gatear primero, ¿no es cierto? Sí, hay niños que no gatean, sino que ¡pah! Ya van directo a caminando, salen caminando, dice. El proceso es, primero tienen que aprender a gatear y de ahí sí a caminar. Entonces dice, el niño que no aprendió a gatear primero es malo para matemáticas. Entonces usted le va a preguntar a su papá, a su mamá, no. Papá, mamá, yo sí pude gatear o directo caminé. Entonces ahí le van a decir, no, tú caminaste primero. Entonces ahí va a deducir usted que si es bueno o malo para matemáticas, ¿no? Pero así dice, si usted aprendió a gatear primero, es bueno para matemáticas. Y es lógico, ¿no? Si usted aprende a gatear, entonces usted aprende a qué. Usted va gateando y si se choca, si no ve, se choca, ¿no es cierto?, con algún objeto, mesa, silla. Pero si usted va a gatear, usted ya calcula más o menos la distancia a una silla, la distancia a la mesa, ¿no es cierto? Si usted va gateando, no va a pasar por las gradas, ¿no es cierto? Gradas hacia abajo, ¿no? Se va a lastimar. Entonces usted ya dice, no, pues si veo las gradas me detengo y no me voy a lastimar. Entonces usted hace el cálculo, mire. Usted hace el cálculo mental. Entonces, por eso es que le dicen que si no gateó, es malo para matemáticas. Sería de ver, ¿no? Sería de comprobar. Entonces, usted tiene líder. Vamos con líder. María is good at... María is good at speaking, public speaking. ¿Yes o no? Are you? Are you? Are you good at speaking in front of people or no? ¿Yes, I am o no?
No, I am not.
I am nervous. Yo también me pongo nervioso. Bueno, con ustedes, con confianza, no hay problema. But in front of people, I am nervous. I forgot Spanish, I forgot English in front of people. Andrés, are you good at public speaking?
No.
No, I am not. You are nervous, ¿no es cierto? You are nervous. Yeah, so you say, for example, Andrés is good at, let's see, Andrés is good at languages, for example, Spanish and English. So he must have been work with this ability. Entonces alguien dice, I know, for example, no, Spanish or English seems to come naturally to him. En caso de español, ¿no es cierto? Tiene facilidad el español. Si es el inglés también, ¿no? Por ejemplo, Sheila, are you good at English? Sheila, are you good at English? Yes, I am, or no, I am not?
No, I am not.
Pero vamos a suponer que sí, ¿no? Conmigo tiene buenas notas. Entonces, Sheila is good at English. She must have been worth with those skills or with this ability. Or you say, she must have been endowed with, no? She must have been endowed with English or with a skill. Or I say, she must have been blessed with this skill, with this ability, ¿no? O de pronto su papi, su mami es profesor de inglés, ¿no? Y de paso, pues le da una manito y usted puede, ¿no es cierto? I know, math, or in this case for Sheila, English seems to come naturally to her, ¿no? Porque se trata de ella. ¿Listo? That is the idea, ¿no? Be endowed with, estar dotado de, o con, be born with, nacer con esa habilidad, con el talento, be blessed with, bendecido con ese talento. Be a born, be gifted, or give natural, be born, I say, be natural, más un sustantivo, o el talento, come naturally to, viene naturalmente con esa persona, ¿no? Vamos al ejercicio siguiente. Me ayuda, por favor, escuchando primero. Ahí va. Permítame compartirle el audio. Yeah. Listen to it.
Guess what I bought today? The newest edition of Guinness World Records.
Cool. Those can be so entertaining. Last year, this kid named Andrew Dahl set a record for blowing up 23 balloons in 3 minutes with his nose. It blew my mind.
Gross.
What are some of this year's achievements?
Chris Walton has the world's longest fingernails, which extend to 19 feet and 9 inches. She stopped cutting them one day, so they've been growing for 18 years.
That's off the charts.
Listen to this. Lady Gaga has the most followers on Twitter.
I follow her. She's not your average Jane.
Here's another. The Super Wanwan Circus in Japan was able to coordinate the largest group of dogs skipping rope simultaneously. 13.
That kind of talent puts them head and shoulders above Lady Gaga.
And Roger Alsop, who is 70 years old, succeeded in swimming across the English Channel, making him the oldest man to do so. That certainly exceeds expectations for someone his age.
Yeah, you have interesting people here, no? For example, you say Andrew Dahl, Chris Walton, Lady Gaga, you see? Lady Gaga, and the Super One Circus, One Circus. So what do they say about these interesting people and the circus, no? So you say, look at this. Guess what I bought today? The newest edition Guinness World Records. Los record Guinness, no? So you say los premios. Yeah. Cool. Those can be so entertaining. Last year, this kid, este chico llamado Andrew Dahl, set a record for blowing up 23 balloons in 3 minutes with the nose. ¿Se imagina inflar los globos? Con la nariz, dice, 23 globos. It blew my mind. Si usted revisa su libro, página 42, you say, it blew my mind. What is the idea? Blew my mind. Discuss extraordinary people and things. He's surprised, ¿no? Le da un grado alto. Fuera de lugar, fuera de serie, ¿no? It blew my mind. Me dejó loco, dice. Gross, what are some of this year's achievements? ¿Cuáles son los logros de este año? Chris Walton, another person, Chris Walton. What does she say about Chris Walton? He has the world's longest fingernails, uñas. De los dedos de la mano, which extend to 19 feet and 9 inches, 19 pies y 9 pulgadas. She stopped cutting them one day. Ella dejó de cortarse las uñas. And these nails have been growing for 18 years. ¿Se imagina? Crecieron las uñas por 18 años. Razón que tiene esa longitud, ¿no? That is off the charts, nuevamente. That is off the charts. What's the idea of the charts? Que sale de lo normal, ¿no es cierto? Ahí tiene. Off the charts. Fuera de lugar. of the charts. Listen to this. Lady Gaga, again, Lady Gaga. She's famous on Twitter. I follow her. Jason is a fan. He's a fan, Lady Gaga. She's not your average Jane. She's not your average Jane. No está tu nivel. She's not your average. Here is another. Super One One Circus. Aquí está el circo. This is in Japan. Was able to coordinate the largest group of dogs skipping rope simultaneously. 13 dogs. 13 perritos there. That kind of talent puts them heads and shoulders over Lady Gaga. Le pasó, le ganó a Lady. Le dejó por el piso, dice. Head and shoulders above Lady Gaga. Claro, le ganó a Lady Gaga. Todo puede ser de Lady Gaga, pero los perritos le ganaron. And Roger Alsop, another one. He is 70 years old. Es un mayor, un hombre de edad de 70 años. Succeeded in swimming across the English Channel. Atravesó nadando el canal inglés, making him the oldest man to do so. That certainly exceeds, ahí tiene la otra, exceeds expectations. Sobrepasó las expectativas, ¿no? O sea, nos dejó sorprendidos. Yeah, that is the information for this chart. El siguiente cuadrito dice, complete. Complete, por favor. Number one, ¿quién nadó a través del canal inglés? ¿Quién era? Regresemos, a ver. ¿Usted me ayuda? Ahí está. ¿Quién es?
Roger Alsop.
Correcto, complete. Roger Alsop, ahí está. Complete, Roger Alsop. Ya está. Now, he was recognized as. How was he recognized? ¿Cómo lo reconocieron? He was recognized as. Ahí tiene.
The oldest man to do so.
Yeah, the oldest man. He was the oldest man, yes. But the expression is head and shoulders above. Imagínense, 70 años. Entonces, ¿qué, ni qué Lady Gaga, ni qué otra cosa, ¿no es cierto? Ahí tiene usted. Head and shoulders above others his age. Completé. Y les quedó corto, ¿no es cierto? Head and shoulders above. Sobresalió ante todos. Number two. The number of Twitter followers that has indicates that her success is. ¿Qué nos falta ahí? Veamos, regresemos. Twitter, Lady Gaga, ¿no? What does it say, Lady Gaga? Your average. So you say, the number of Twitter followers that Lady Gaga, ¿no? Complete, Lady Gaga, si está bien. Has indicates that her success is, ¿qué le ponemos? Her success is, ¿alguien me ayuda? Her success is, Lady Gaga. Her success is average. Veamos. Of the charts. Fuera de serie, ¿no? Of the charts. Complete. Of the charts. Number three. Who blew up the most balloons with his nose? What is the name?
Andrew Dahl.
Andrew Dahl. Correcto. Andrew Dahl. Bien. Y certainly not. What is the expression? He blew up the most balloons with his nose. Is certainly not off the chart. Not your average. Veamos. Your average, Joe. Complete. Your average, Joe. Another name, number four, hasn't cut her nails in 18 years. What is the lady? Who is the lady? ¿Me ayuda? Who is the lady?
Chris Walt. Walton.
Okay. Chris Walton. Christina, no? Chris Walton. Christy. Chris Walton. She shows dedication that has exceeded everyone's. Está fácil porque tengo exceeded everyone's. ¿Quién me ayuda? Expectations. Complete, por favor. Expectation. Ahí tiene expectations. Y la última, me ayuda, por favor, el nombre. The fact that it is not a person. ¿Eh? The fact that. What is the name of the circus? Super 1-1 circus, ¿no? Had the most dogs jumping rope. At the same time, completely blew the spectators' minds. Complete. Blew the spectators' minds. ¿Listo? Blew the spectators' minds. Yeah, that's it. Let's continue with correct the mistakes. Continuamos. Yeah, me quedan solo 6 minutitos. A ver, ahí va.
Okay.
Listos, tiene. Me ayuda leyendo, tenga la bondad. Helen, Charlotte, her courtesy.
Charlotte, her courtesy will be a beneficial asset to our team.
Yeah, Charlotte is, she's the possible employee, empleada, ¿no? They have to be qualified, tienen que calificar, ser calificados para ocupar el puesto, ¿no? There is a job. So her courtesy will be beneficial asset to our team. Hablamos de la cortesía de ella, ¿no? That is one commentary. Juan Sebastián, they learned. Pete, they learned.
Pete, they learned he had been promoted at his other job.
Yeah, Pete. Los que están calificando, they learned that he had been promoted at his other job. En otro trabajo él fue promovido. Bob, ¿qué dice María Augusta? Bob, he acted
professionally until he complimented Josh loudly during the interview.
Yeah, he is another possible employee. He acted professionally until he complimented Josh loudly during the interview. Yeah, he is a professional. Hasta, until he complimented Josh loudly during the interview. Pero luego él, este Bob, contestó en forma muy, you say loudly, ¿no? De pronto se expresó muy fuerte. O muy groseramente. Jair, he presented. Aaron, he presented. ¿Qué dice sobre Aaron Camacho? Siga. He presented.
He presented his will and was wearing a pair of sloping jeans and a shirt.
Ya, tenga la bondad. Faltan todavía 4 minutitos. Alguien está ingresando o saliendo, no sé. Faltan 4 minutitos todavía. Yeah, he presented himself well and was wearing a pair of sloppy jeans and t-shirt. Mire, estaba bien presentadito este señor Aaron. Vamos con Ismael. She is Susie.
She is inexperienced but will probably improve over time.
Ajá, she is inexperienced. No está muy, no es muy experimentada, but she probably will improve herself, ¿no? Ella puede mejorar si le guían, ¿no? Entonces, de tarea, usted va a completar este cuadrito, pero con el siguiente diálogo. Ahí va. Haga la captura, por favor. ¿Dónde está? No, no, ahí esas son las respuestas. Ya me están saliendo las respuestas. A ver, permítame. Ya, ahí está. Ahí está, ¿no? Ese es el cuadrito.
Yeah. Okay, Josh. Anne's Spectacular Seafood is holding its grand opening in 2 weeks. We need to decide whom we want to hire. What are your opinions of the people we've interviewed?
Since Charlotte has 2 years of server experience, she is absolutely qualified. However, I didn't feel comfortable around Pete. Judging from how many jobs he has been fired from, he isn't reliable.
I respect your judgment. So that's it. He doesn't cut the mustard.
I'd like to hire Bob, though. He really fits the bill, and he would definitely impress our customers.
Really? He acted professionally at first, but then he cursed right in front of us. To me, he doesn't make the grade.
Oh, yeah. I forgot how he fell flat on his face. Instead, let's give Aaron a chance and see how he measures up. He was courteous and well-dressed.
What about Susie?
She has little practical experience, but with training, she could make the cut.
Then I think that's everyone we need.
You see, according to this, complete exercise B, page 43. ¿Listos? Y ahí nos quedamos. Ahora sí, ahí nos quedamos. Jóvenes, esa es la tarea, ¿sí? Cortita, mire, solo tiene que leer y poner si califica o no califica. Nada más. ¿Listo? Nos vemos, chicos. Bye, bye. Bye, bye.